guys, it's Morgan, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to be talking about episode 13 of season 4 of Riverdale, chapter 70, The Ides of March. Now, if you haven't seen the episode, there will be spoilers in this review, so stop watching if you don't want to be spoiled. With that said, here's my review of episode 13 of season 4 of Riverdale, chapter 70, The Ides of March. I did feel sorry for Archie when it looked like he wouldn't be able to graduate high school with his friends, but at the same time, it makes sense. Since Archie spent a lot of time out of school when he was on the run, it'll be hard to make that up. The fact that Mr. DuPont told Jughead that he's out of the Quill and Skull and that his Baxter Brothers contract could be terminated was totally unfair. I am still suspicious about the Quill and Skull, but Jughead deserved his Baxter Brothers contract, so I was really hoping he would be able to keep it. Even though it did annoy me that because of his contract, another Ghost Rider is allowed to embellish Jughead's story. It was pretty obvious that the girl Tony met with was Hermosa in disguise, obviously working for Hiram, and at first I thought that Tony didn't know, so when it was revealed that she did know and planned a trap with Cheryl and Veronica, I was relieved. And I also felt really sorry for Veronica when she found out that Hiram told Hermosa about his condition, but didn't tell Veronica. Right when Jughead went to get his old laptop to prove he didn't plagiarize his story, I knew it was going to be gone. Just another way the Quill and Skull members are trying to make things hard for Jughead, so I was really hoping that Jughead would be able to prove his innocence. It was a really stupid thing to do when Archie took the blame for the flask that was found in Veronica's locker, but it also proved how much Archie loves Veronica, and that was proven even more based on the advice he gave her when she told him about Hiram's condition and how she didn't know what to do. Archie has done a lot of stupid things, but he is a great boyfriend. When Betty told Donna to tell the truth if she's lying about having an affair with Mr. Chipping, I just thought, you really think Donna would admit to lying? It would be nice if it were that easy, but it obviously wasn't. Brett is very good at making me hate him more and more, and in this episode, that happened when he told Jughead that he did have a tape of Jughead and Betty together and was using it to blackmail Jughead. Can Brett just please get what's coming to him already? It was really upsetting when Jughead agreed to leave Stonewall Prep, but I do understand that he did it for Betty. It shows how much he loves her. But when he accepted Donna and Brett's party invitation, I was just thinking, why would you do that? Obviously, something bad is going to happen. Now, based on the end of the episode, it looks like I can't say that Jughead's death is part of Jughead's story, but it does explain how Brett and Donna were able to get Betty to do it. Since Donna visited Evelyn in jail and learned that by saying tangerine 3 times, she can hypnotize Betty. This might be a little far-fetched, but I'm still holding on to the hope that Jughead's alive, because if he's really dead, then how was he narrating the end of the episode? Maybe it is his story. Thanks for watching, guys. If you saw the episode, let me know in the comments what you thought about it. And if you want to see any of my previous Riverdale reviews, check out the playlist. And if you want to see any of my future videos, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!